How y'all doing? So some of you know that I'm from Dublin. And in probably about the 90s, late 80s into the 90s, I used to do my shopping downtown and I would walk home to my little apartment just on the edge of the city centre. And Sinead O'Connor used to go to a voice trainer around the corner from my apartment. So we used to always bump into each other, almost on a weekly basis. We'd always say hello to each other. I got a ton of friends of mine who are good friends with her. And to tell you that Ireland is super, super hurting this week is an understatement. So I hope you'll join me on this.
TV, shocked by the deaths took place in Beijing. Strange that she should be offended. Same orders given by her. I've said this before now. You said I was childish. You'll say it now. Remember why what I told you. They hated me, they will hate you. England's not the mythical land of Madam George and Rose, home of police who kill black boys on mopeds. I love my boy, that's why I'm leaving. I want him to be aware that any such thing as grief.
Grandmother down in Smithfield, right there looking for food for her kids. In her arms she holds three cold babies, and the first words that they learned were please. These are dangerous days. To say what you feel is to dig your own grave. Remember what I told you. You were of the world, they would love you. It's not the biblical land of Madame George and her roses, the home of police who kill black on mopeds. And I love my boy, and that's why I'm leaving. I don't want him to be aware that there's any such thing as grieving.
Not the mythical land, Madame George and Rose, home of police who kill black boys on mopeds. I love my boy, that's why I'm leaving. Don't want him to be aware there's any such thing as grief.
So I just want to start by saying, you know, I'm not Mark Dignam, so I didn't know Sinead O'Connor. I have friends with her, but I was also about 13 years younger, or I am 13 years younger than she was. So I was super little, you know, when some of this stuff was coming out, and even being really small, you know, things really impacted me a lot, and I think what was most important to me, and I had like at this period when I was about 14 where I was just like engulfed in all of Sinead O'Connor's music, was this permission for vulnerability, like this permission to be this authentic, real human being, you know, in the face of a lot of people who punished her greatly for doing that. So this, you know, in terms of celebrity deaths, I mean, I feel like I've seen a lot of people post about it, but this one was particularly intense for me, just because she's been such an important influence in my life. And she, I really feel like that a lot of what that is for me sort of rules my work as a therapist, too. So I'm really excited to be able to do this, and I don't sound like Sinead O'Connor, so don't expect me to.
It's been 7 hours and 15 days since you took your love away. Go out every night and sleep all day since you took your love away. Since you've been
such a pleasure and an honor to sing. Thank you so much.
But I do have one last thing that I want to say is I was watching an interview today on the BBC, an old interview with Sinead from about 20 years ago. Some of you just little kids. But she said three things, and they're short. So I just wanted to repeat them because I thought they were they were worthwhile to repeat, and I think they say a lot about her. The first one was, I may be silly, but I'm not stupid. Right? And then the second one was, when you sing, you pray twice. Powerful. Not her own words. But this last one was her own words. Be yourself at all costs.
Your grave and the lie there for it.
Okay, hi everybody. I'm so unprepared. I hope it's worth it. Does anybody have a dollar bill I can borrow? I'll give it back. Any dollar. 20? The higher the better. Okay, thanks. I'm gonna do magic tricks. Sadly, we lost somebody very important, Sinead O'Connor, recently. And, yeah, it's a big bummer. But I made an arrangement of the song Nothing Compares to You for solo guitar. And I'm just amazed. It's a Prince song, first of all, and we all know that. But Sinead O'Connor killed it, that song. So there's a whole lot of soul in her voice, and especially in that song. So I tried to capture, this is like a hybrid version of the Prince version and Sinead O'Connor. So this is Nothing Compares to You.
Thank you. That was a Sinead O'Connor song. It's my little tribute to her as well. I met her one time, and we were both so shy we didn't speak a word, but we just smiled at each other, and yeah, that was it. But it was, yeah. So this is another Sinead O'Connor song here. Yes. And it's on the same key, I'm guessing.
You want me to play?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
We like the Glock.
All right. Doesn't take a lot of space.
let me think. Thank you.